Last year's Georgia win has been a rallying cry this week for Alabama.
We're set for the kick.
Rocket.
It's Hastings at the 12. And he's brought down at the 25-yard line. That's where Greg Talley will take the offense. Talley is sacked back to the 21. Steve Webb, a 6-foot-5 senior, 3rd and 5 for the Tide. Let's make that 3rd and 8. Stacy,
look out.
He's got some room. And he'll have a first down. 3rd with 5 to go. Woodson throws complete.
Georgia's got a fumble.
Georgia has the ball. Pass is complete, just short of the first down marker, to Arthur Marshall. Strong in motion. Hurst with a lot of room for the first down. 2nd and 11. There's a fumble, and Alabama comes up with it.
And that's the result.
And then later on, you'll see a host of games, including Georgia Tech and Clemson. Back to the action. Kevin Turner breaks it all the way inside to the 11-yard line of Georgia. He's stopped up by John Allen, a gain of 24 yards. Woodson tries to take off, but falls down at the 15-yard line, but he did get the ball into the middle of the field. So Matt Wethington will come in to kick for Alabama. This is his first field goal attempt of the season. Gene Stallings knows nothing about how he will kick in game situation.
His first as an Alabama Rolling Tide.
32-yard attempt. It's blocked. And no good. Somebody got a piece of that. 3rd and 7 for the Bulldogs. Greg Talley still at quarterback. Play action. He's in trouble. Talley puts his head down, and there's a flag on the play.
Dead ball. Pippy.
Well, Georgia going the wrong way. They got to get it straight. Let's make it 3rd and 29 at the 14.
That's a taxi ride.
A handoff to Larry Ware. And he swarmed again. 3rd and 6 for the Tide. And complete over the middle to the 45-yard line. Derek Vlasic with a tremendous concentration chop to hang on to the ball. Backs are in the eye. This one goes to Turner. Makes a nice cut. It gets close to the 40, about the 43. Alabama moving the ball. It's 3rd and 3. Play action. Woodson rolls. And he's caught from behind by number 42, Dwayne Simmons. Simmons has been everywhere on the field tonight. Tank Williamson comes in to punt for Alabama. He'll try and pooch this one inside the 10. And he gets a fantastic bounce. They down it at the 3. And Zaire will be very close to the first down. It depends on the spot. Larry Ware. Great balance. And he's out over the 23 to the 24. and more motion up front. Flags all over the field. Zaire rolls out.
Offside defense.
Strong, and where are the backs? Completes the pass to number 12, Arthur Marshall. Where? He'll have the first down and almost broke away for more. He's stopped up by George Teague. Second and 9. Play action. Zaire's got a man wide open. Complete to Kevin Maxwell at the 2-yard line.
There's a flag though, Mark. This is going to be against Georgia too. They're going to bring it back.
Oh my, how that one will hurt. Georgia holding on to the ball for over 6 minutes. Zaire sacked by Antonio London. David Palmer's in the ball game. Donnie Finkley is the split end. Woodson, play action. Drops the ball. Georgia could have had it, but it looked like Alabama had it, got it back. Early home, and it's 3rd and 15 for Alabama. Complete over the middle. Woodson really rifled it in there for Kevin Lee. With speed, 1st and 10 for Alabama. The reverse to Lee. And he's got some room. He's got one man to beat. Kevin Lee takes it down to the 17-yard line.
They're going to call this against Saran Stacy, I believe.
A senior as well. 1st and 10. Woodson is sacked back at the 50-yard line. Nothing giddy about this game so far. 2nd and 22 for Alabama. Woodson completes the pass of the 28 to Saran Stacy. Great mobility by Danny Woodson. 21 yards in the play. Woodson takes it himself. He's down to the 23 with 8 seconds to play. And the clock stops. Dwayne Simmons on the tackle. 153 wins. And they've won 9 of the last 10 night games here at Bryant-Denny. Wethington misses it. He goes 0 for 2. And this half will end with zeros on the scoreboard. An inside shovel pass. The ball goes on the ground. Stacy recovers it, and there's a flag on the play.
That's an incompleted pass.
Zaire in trouble, dumps it off to Shannon Mitchell. 2nd and 6. Zaire hits Frank Harvey. Rolls out nicely to complete the pass. Ball on the 28-yard line now for Georgia. Harvey. Nothing doing. Antonio London, the left linebacker, making the stop. Zaire completes it to Larry Ware. Ware deep inside Alabama territory to the 8-yard line. 22 yards and a pass and catch. 1st and goal from the 8. Almost intercepted. The pass attempt going to Kevin Maxwell was broken up by George T. Play action. There's a fumble. And Alabama has the ball.
He can't advance it. He can't advance it. Bring it back.
John Copeland and Steve Webb made the stop and the sack on Eric Zier.
Or if you are going to get sacked, puck it away.
Kevin Turner. Tough running, close to the first down. Stacy is the deep back. He gets the toss. And I don't think he made the first down.
No, he should have enough for the first.
Third and four. Woodson, incomplete.
Almost made that catch. Tried to scoop it and get his hands under it.
So Coolpee couldn't make it. Chuck Carswell takes the punt. And he busts it up the middle. Carswell takes it down to the 41-yard line. A 40-yard punt and a 35-yard return. Hand off to Hurst. He's got some room. Garrison Hurst with a nice run over the right side. Garrison Hurst. He'll be short of the first down.
Ray Goff knows he's got a guy that can bang it through.
And of course, last year this game was decided on a last second field goal.
Peterson's only 3 for 7, though. He struggled, but he's got a pretty good leg.
This one will come from 24 yards out.
Do you believe this?
No, I don't. He missed. Three missed field goals, all from relatively close range. Second and 7 for Denny Woodson in Alabama. A pass tip but complete to Prince Wembley. It's 3rd and 1. Wembley's out wide. Stacy with the first down. Stacy is the deep back. Woodson looking for a receiver. He completes it to Ricky Brown.
Did you see what Woodson did that time?
He's coming off an elbow injury last week against Florida. Play action. David Palmer makes the reception at the 35. That's the man they want to integrate in this Alabama offense. First and 10. Stacy cuts back. Saran Stacy takes it down to the 15. The longest run of the day for Saran Stacy. First and 10 from the 16. What a juke. What a move at the line of scrimmage by Saran Stacy. First and goal. Stacy, he'll score. Second and 5. Ball on the 35-yard line. Ware. Larry Ware takes it down to the 41-yard line.
And you know what?
If he wasn't tripped up, he might have gone further.
They're going to bring it back for holding against Georgia.
3rd and 12. A little movement on the right side. Zier is sacked by Eric Curry. For Alabama 33. Here's Palmer on the reverse. And Stacy keeps it. Saran Stacy had me fooled.
Yep, working on his knee.
Arduously did it all last year. 2nd and 10. The referee rules it complete over the middle to Curtis Brown.
Look at the defense.
He's a freshman. Watch this. Ball's gone right there on the ground. And yet he's pretty smart for a freshman. That's a great act.
Oh, boy. Stacy to the six.
You're going to get another flag here for Georgia if they don't watch out.
He was running to the fence.
Big, big play here.
Stacy stopped up inside the two. Hemp Green from 18 yards out. No doubt.
In whose mind?
Third and four. And Zaire fumbles it.
Georgia recovers the ball.
Tight end lines up to the left. Robert Turner. Stopped by Dwayne Simmons, but he pulled his way close to the 34, short of the first down. First and 10. And Robert Stewart had a big answer for Larry Ware. A crucial series for the Georgia. Lobbed up and incomplete. Second and seven. Martin Houston, a load at 235 pounds, runs for the first down, 20 yards. 235, and he used every pound. First and 10. This is Lynch. And Woodson's done a credible job on offense tonight. It's third and seven. You jinxed him. Didn't fool anyone on that play. Man, what about those Boston Red Sox putting the heat on the Toronto Blue Jays? Third and four now for Georgia. Max Strong. Greg Goff looking very pensive on the sideline. Gets the first down. Second down and eight. Now Georgia goes to the shotgun. Zaire got whacked. And the pass is complete at the 37. But man, did Zaire get hit. It's first and 10. Zaire looks for Hastings. It's tipped. There's a flag on the play and caught.
It's going to
by
be
Damon Evans.
It's going to be interference back there, but again, Zaire took a heck of a lick, and he's having a tough time getting up.
Well, unlike 1990, there will be no comeback magic for the Georgia Bulldogs, barring a miracle, of course, here with 24 seconds to go. Zaire fumbles. They're ruling it an incomplete pass now. That makes it fourth and 10.
Zaire can't wait to get in the shower right now.
Three receivers out to the left for Georgia. But they won't even catch the ball. Eric Curry living in the backfield. Living large.
Only fitting that you have Lord Wedgwood and Prince Webley in the same stadium.
And a royal performance tonight by Alabama. That'll be the last play of the ball game. Danny Woodson kneels down. That his team was going to be shut out, but that's the way it ends, 10 to nothing.